Apple is releasing a new phone, you'll see a number of companies are continuously releasing new phones. Not all of these new phones will have 5G right away, just because some of those technical issues are still there. They take a lot of area, takes a lot of power, and there's a number of dimensions that these companies are trying to optimize. It's estimated that maybe $1 or 2 trillion are spent worldwide on cell phone technologies in different aspects today. So of course you're seeing a large amount of investment in China, in Europe, and elsewhere.
We are in our mixed reality studio to get the big picture on 5G and learn just how this connectivity works. Sandeep, tell us, how is 5G different from what we're seeing out there today?
So 5G, of course, stands for fifth generation. So today you have your fourth generation cell phone, like LTE, and 5 generation will be the next advancement in that. So it has a number of technologies to try to deliver higher data rates, lower latency, that means faster connections, and also maybe connecting many more devices than just your smartphone.
A 4G wave or 2G wave or 3G wave probably looks a little something like this. How is that different from what a 5G wave would look like?
So, as you drew there, all radio signals are waves. That means the signal goes up and down, just like that. What happens in 5G is that the wavelength, that's the rate at which it goes up and down, becomes much, much smaller.
Gotcha. So something like this?
Yeah, perfect.
And how is that beneficial? Why is that, say, better than what's happening with 4G or 2G or 3G?
So what's good about this is when in these frequencies, you can transmit much, much higher data rates in those high frequencies.
And so this spectrum that we're seeing over here is largely unused, correct?
That's right.
So it's going to give us more space and allow for some of the advantages that you were talking about, lower latency, faster download times, that kind of thing.
Exactly. And many more devices that can be connected as well.
Gotcha. And it's not as clogged up as what we're seeing in the waves, say, down here.
That's right. And your operator has to purchase the license to use that frequency. Now, the problem is that the frequencies that current systems are running on is very congested. So it's extremely expensive for operators to buy new spectrum in these bands. And that cost is coming to you, the consumer. So operators and anyone who wants wireless technology is looking for a new spectrum.
So Sandeep, if we had a city that looks like this and the millimeter wave is fully deployed, what kind of connectivity would we be able to see that's different from what we have today?
So right now, if you're walking around a city, you could have, you say, your connectivity with a smartphone. Mm-hmm. But in 5G, you could imagine many more things could be connected. So for example, a lot of people are talking about smart cars or autonomous driving. Those are cars need to have lots of sensor data, and you might want to send that up to the cloud while driving so that it can be given to other cars or be used for computing your navigation and avoiding accidents and keeping things safe. So these are kinds of things which need very high amounts of bandwidth that are really difficult to do in 4G today, but could be opened up with potentially for 5G.
These millimeter waves seem to be really beneficial. I mean, they can transfer a lot more data than we've seen in the past. They can have these smart cars talk to each other. But what kind of challenges would they encounter in a city that looks like this?
That's a good question. So there's really two challenges with the millimeter waves. The first is that at the higher frequencies, they don't go as far. So you have to concentrate the transmissions in a narrow directional beam, unlike today's transmissions, which kind of just disperse everywhere, what they call omnidirectionally.
Gotcha.
The second problem is those signals can get blocked by a lot of materials. So for example, you might be inside right now in your home watching this, and you can get a cell phone connection through the walls and windows of your house. But that might be very difficult in a millimeter wave case. So the signals are blocked much more. So if it's trying to get to something behind me, it's only the amount that kind of gets around or diffracts around me is going to make it through, which is only a tiny fraction of that energy.
So what's the solution there? How can 5G be deployed if it's going to get stopped by somebody standing on the street or another building?
So there's two solutions. Like I said, you transmit in these narrow directional beams. You have to find other paths to get the signal to the intended destination. Mm-hmm. That might not be the direct path. You might end up sending the signal and reflecting it off a building wall, but it'll still have enough strength probably to get you there. But you have to do some kind of beam searching to find that path.
So instead of maybe traveling a direct line from this building to this building, the wave might shoot off of this building, reflect off of it, and then go to this building from here.
Great line.
But then we would have to have a lot more transmitters, correct?
Yeah, that's the other way to do this, is that you may not be able to find any path, in which case you need a lot more cell sites that your cell phone or whatever wireless device can find.
So where would those cell sites go?
So right now, though, that's always been a very difficult problem, particularly if you're watching this in the U.S., to find cell sites. So they go onto, they say, the side of a building, maybe onto roadside infrastructure like a light post. But this is something that carriers are going to have to find and spend money to get. On top of that, when they get the cell site, that's not enough. They have to get power to that cell site, plus they need connectivity to that cell site as well.
So when would we actually see 5G, do you think?
Well, if you're in one of the selected cities, you can actually start experimenting with 5G today, when it'll be probably more nationwide, probably even about maybe 12 months or so. So it's kind of around the corner.
Hey, NBC News viewers, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.